And now I'd like to introduce Eric from Washington, D.C. Eric, where? Awesome. Hi.
So hi, I'm Eric Litman. I run In Front of Projectors and a small venture capital fund in Washington, D.C. called, appropriately, Washington, D.C. We're about as early stage as you get. We tend to get into deals anywhere from early to somewhere along the lines of way too early, which means a lot of the stuff we do is seed stage, it's idea stage. It's about as preliminary as you can get in the course of a deal. But I'm going to share a little bit of news tonight that's probably a little bit different than what you think in terms of venture capital. Reality is, most companies, sorry, can you hear me now? There we go. All right. The reality is, most companies should not be looking for venture capital. I'm not here looking for deals, although if anybody has something absolutely amazing and world-changing, I'd love to talk to you, come to me afterwards. But these are the numbers, and these numbers don't lie. Last year, 3,813 companies or deals were done. A very small number. One out of every 100 deals that a venture capital firm will even look at, probably look at somewhere in the range of 1,000 to 4,000 or 5,000 deals in the course of a deal for every firm. Chances are very likely you're not going to get money from a venture capitalist. So what do you do? What do you do? You either go the traditional route of trying to find some source of money from somebody you know, whether it's friends or family, whether it's the angel investing route, whether it's an SBA loan. These are all the things that you're going to hear at every single venture capital talk, and every single venture capitalist you know is ultimately going to say something like this to you. But there's a lot more. I think there's an emerging trend right now in the social media space that is dramatically empowering, that gives companies, gives people, gives individuals the opportunity to go out, build a brand, build a business around their individual brand, build a business around themselves without having to put any money into it. The cost to build a company today is dramatically lower than it's ever been before. Open source technologies, lots and lots and lots of people who get the space, who understand the internet, who understand technology, who understand how to engage, and short, very clear paths to ultimately entering markets make it so much easier than it's ever been to build a company. So how do you get there? With a broken image. All right, I'm gonna skip this. Sorry, we had some technical issues in translation here. What you would have seen, had this actually existed, was Rick Astley playing his famous, video. The message is, if there's hope for Rick, there's hope for you. Thanks to social media, Rick Astley is actually going back out on tour now. He just put together an 8-show tour, and I guarantee you within the next 12 months, the guy's probably gonna do 50, 100 shows around the country because of social media. Because somebody out there at some point in time figured out that watching Rick Astley do his little dance on stage was ridiculously funny, and probably funnier than anything anybody else was gonna look at any point in time, and they built a meme around it. So where does that leave you? Okay, so that leads you to building social capital versus going out and looking for venture capital. Social capital is where we want to talk tonight. This is something that's never really been able to be deployed in terms of a business, in terms of an opportunity prior to today. But because of the availability of social networks, because of the accessibility of audiences, and the ease with which you can build a brand, it's frankly, from my perspective, it's a much better funding source for most people. So how do you do this? How do you leverage social capital to go out and find a way to build your company? Well, there are a few things. So first off, it's about engaging. It's about being real. It's about finding the people who can be the absolute best evangelists for what you do. Okay, so how do you do that? You go out and you talk. You find your voice. You find who it is that you are. You find what it is that's relevant about what you do, about your company, about your space, about your opportunity, and you communicate, and you do it regularly, and you do it with diligence, you hustle. So, what are the channels for doing this? I'm sure, let me just see a quick sign of hands here. How many people here are on Twitter? Wow, not a big number. Not enough. How many people here are on Facebook?
Too many!
How many people here log into Facebook or Twitter once a week or more? Okay, it's a big number. And chances are, in and among the sphere of the types of people you're going to want to influence early on, the numbers look really similar. So how do you move beyond? How do you get to the place where you have 1,000 fans, 1,000 people, 1,000 voices talking about what you're doing? Well, the reality is most of us aren't going to reach that number with people we know. We have some reasonable sphere of influence among our real-life friendships, among our real-life relationships, real-life business contacts, but the ability to scale those is limited by your ability to go out and meet people face-to-face. So the next step, moving beyond the people you know, is to go out and find people in the community that are interested in hearing what you have to say, they're interested in knowing what you do, and about whom you can find, or I should say about with, you can find some point of commonality, whether it's relationship, whether it's shared interest in a product, whether it's shared interest in a service. These are the relationships that you ultimately want to capitalize on, that you ultimately want to build, and you want to turn into your personal brand evangelist. Because the more you're able, in the course of your engagements in the community, the more you're able to dialogue with people who you can actually look for value to, rather than looking for people from whom you can get value, the more you're ultimately going to see return from all of this. So, it's about capturing opportunity, finding people that are interesting and relevant to you, finding people that are able to engage with you on your product or on your service, and turning them into ambassadors for your product. So.